Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Daryl. I'm the assistant front office manager here. Would you like to introduce yourself?
So my name is Algo. I'm working here in the front office department, and I've been here for 6 months already.
6 months, I see. Mm-hmm. Do you know the purpose of the training here today?
Oh yeah. As long as I'm concerned, I'm here for training.
Training. All right. Okay. So the main issue is recently we've got a lot of complaints from guests about the front office staff. And most of the complaints were relating to transaction issues. So the hotel has decided to have a training for all the front office staff. So we're not saying that you're at fault particularly, but it's just training for all the staff.
Okay.
I already set up the computer. Would you like to see?
Oh, sure.
Well, hello.
So
this is the office assistant. I'm sure you're familiar with that.
Right, so this will be the lesson plan for today's training.
I'll just go through it with you one by one. Mm-hmm. So the outcome of this training is we need to learn four things, practice four things.
Okay.
First will be how to collect the deposit amount from the guest. Second will be how to post the deposit amount.
Right.
Print the receipt. Third will be how to post payments for miscellaneous charges, post charges for miscellaneous charges. And fourth will be how to split the transaction and share with another room.
Okay.
Yeah. So for the purpose of this training, I've already made a reservation. And the arrivals, yeah. Jenny Lin, and let me just check her info.
Okay.
Alright, and she's in room 313. So after you check in the guest, you have to collect the payment from the guest. In this case, yeah. So it says here she'll be staying for 2 nights.
Mm.
So how much will you collect for that?
Based on the Taylor International Hotel policy, I believe it's 200 per night, so 200 times 2, which is 400 ringgit.
Correct, 400 ringgit in addition with the room payment.
Okay, room payment.
Right, so in this case, it will be 742.40.
Okay.
Alright, so when you collect the payment, what you do is you post the payment and the deposit on the billing.
Okay.
And start from so you go payment, and let's assume for the exercise they pay in cash. So 724.40. Right, and then here you put room payment.
Okay.
Room. And then you post. Now you do the same thing again for deposit. Normally when you post a payment, you'll be given an option to print the receipt.
Yeah.
So normally if a guest say you click yes, but for this practice we'll say no. And then you post another payment for cash, and this time 400, as you said, 400 per night. And you put deposit. Now when you put this deposit, it's important that you put for how many nights you collected the deposit for. So in this case we did 2 nights.
Okay.
Again, so we say no. For printing a receipt, for example, say just now you're given the option form to print the receipt, but if you say accidentally print no and then they want to print, what you can do is go to folio and you can print the folio. That's correct. Yeah, so it's printing right. Another question I'd like to ask you is why do you think we collect 200 as a deposit per night?
So that thing is for the miscellaneous charges.
Mm-hmm.
For example, the guests consume minibar item,
right?
Or they watch a subscription TV for in the hotel.
That's correct.
You can directly deduct it from the deposit.
Right. No worries. So I'm gonna teach you how to post charges. Now let me just transfer this to the second window. So now when it comes to charges, posting charges, we have a lot of complaints. We need the transaction amount is always not the same. So let me give you an example on why this happens. One of the major reasons why this happens. Say someone has lunch at Zen Chinese.
Yes.
And the total bill is 116 ringgit.
Yes.
So what normally the staff will do is they'll post the amount 116 and then they put 116 here straight and then they post.
Yeah.
The main issue is the computer has not calculated GST or the service charge yet. So after you post 160, and you can drop here, the total is 134.56 cents. That's because the staff who posted didn't account for GST and service charge. So in order for us to get the correct amount, we have to post before GST and before service charge. So in this case, you'll post 100 ringgit, and the additional 16 ringgit will be the GST and service charge. And then after you post that, you have the correct amount. Now the last thing I'm going to teach you will be how to split the bill. So example, two people had lunch from two different rooms, and one guy says, oh, charge it to my room, but both of them want to bill. So what you can do is, to split the bill, you have to just right click on the charges. You don't have to split the service charge or the GST, because they're automatically split. So you just click the, in this case, the Zen Chinese post. Click split transaction. And then you'd be given an amount. You can split by amount, say 10, one person pay 100, one person pay 10. Or you split by percentage. In this case, we'll do 15%. Right? And there you go, it's been split by 2, and the GST and service charge has also been split by 2. So to transfer is very easy, you just click the three charges, click, and then you click transfer transaction. And then here you'll be given a room. So let's transfer to room 207. Yep, and then all the three charges have been transferred. So it'll show up in her account.
Okay.
Alright. So I've already showed you what to do. Would you like to just recap what I just taught you?
Okay, sure.
Alright, so how much do you collect for the deposit?
So we collect base one night, which is 200, plus the room rate.
Correct.
For the payment.
Alright, correct. Now, how do you post? You can just answer. Type in console. Okay, so how would you post the room payment and the deposit?
So, for room payment, we post in underpayment. Then we put 724.40, the room rate of the guest.
Okay.
And then we type room payment.
Okay.
And we post it.
Right. So if a guest wants receipt, you just get receipt.
Press. Okay. Then for the deposit, we post it separately, which is 400 ringgit. And then we write deposit for 2 nights.
Yes, correct.
And then post.
Now here's a very important question. Why do we post separately for a deposit and the room payment?
I think it, you know, because it's not only us who will post, you know, there's a lot of other front office staff.
Yeah.
So later we know which one is for room charges, which one for deposit that we can return to the guest.
Yes, correct. This is so we don't get confused later on when another guest wants to check out.
Okay.
Yeah, correct.
Other than that, to post such as F&B charges, I write here food. Then for example, they eat in the Wasabi restaurant.
Okay.
So their bill is 160. We shield minus with the 10% GST and 6% service. 10%.
Yeah, no worries.
And 6% GST.
Yes, correct.
So I put 100.
Yep.
And I just post. And then close. Something like this.
Yeah, correct. Alright, now how do you split the bill?
Okay, so right click this one.
Mm-hmm.
Split transaction, for example, they want to split half out for 50%, then it will come here. Then after that, I click this, transfer transaction to, for example, their another guest room number, for example, this apartment, which is under room number 410, and then just enter and then transfer.
Yes, yes. Okay, that's very good. You seem to have a full understanding on how to use transactions properly. Alright, so now that this is done, let me just recap the whole exercise.
Okay.
Now, before I go on, do you have any questions for me you'd like to ask about this exercise?
I would like to ask, you know, when we want to transfer room charges, for example, like when they're doing the checkout, they said they eat it with their friend.
Correct.
So they want to transfer charge to another room. So do we directly just transfer it to the other room, or we should ask, you know, permission first.
So normally what we do is we normally ask permission. We have to ask permission from the other guests before we transfer to their room.
Okay.
Because otherwise the guest might just transfer to some random room, right?
Okay.
So normally what we do is, if they aren't at the counter with the other guests, what we can do is we can call them. We can call the room or call their mobile number. If they do not answer, we cannot transfer the charges until we get confirmation from the guests staying in the room.
Right. Other than that, what if I accidentally post the wrong, what is that called, wrong charges?
Okay.
Can I delete it?
You can't delete it, but you can actually alter it. Say, let's just put... Okay, let me just give you an example. Say for this one, you posted wrongly. Right, say you posted wrongly. Maybe it's actually 51 before tax. Correct? So you can actually go here and you can actually change the amount. Yeah, so you can change 55. Yeah, so there's actually no issue. You can actually change it after you post. We can. The only thing we cannot change is payment. If you post the payment wrongly, we cannot change that unless you are a supervisor. So no worries, but the only issue we have is when you post wrongly, the other staff, maybe the front office staff, because maybe we're in the F&B department, the front office staff might not know what is correct and what is wrong, so we'll just present it to the guests. That's why it's always important to double check. You can always change the amount later. Alright, do you have any other questions?
No, that's it for now.
Okay, no worries. Alright, so I have a few questions for you, just to refresh your memory, test your knowledge. When billing, posting billing, what if the guest wants to make a payment by credit card?
I think it's the same process. I just directly combine all the, what is that called, the room rate and the deposit, and then do pre-authorization.
Yes, correct. Yeah. We do what is called pre-authorization, like you said. So we take the amount, the room rate, plus the deposit, but we do a pre-authorization, in which case we just hold the amount.
Okay.
So we don't actually post under billing, we post in a separate account. I'll just show you that some other time. And we, because pre-authorization means we're just holding money, we haven't taken anything yet, so we can't post it in the system.
Okay.
Yeah. Alright, so I have another question for you is, what do you think the amount is 200 ringgit per night, not 300 ringgit?
I think it's normal for every hotel to, I mean 5-star hotel to take 200, because normally they will consume mini bar item, which is quite pricey as well.
Okay.
And using spa like that.
So the reason we came up with the 200 is mainly because that seems to cover most of the cost, say for lunch or minibar. So, and this is also to help the guests as well, because say you want to have this will help the guests because it's 200, it's a fixed amount, so it's easier for them to understand.
Okay.
And another question is, what happens if a guest does not want to pay for their deposit?
I'm not really sure for that. I think I just force them to ask or refer to my superior.
Okay. So, in case your supervisors are not allowed, so what you can do is, if they insist they do not want to pay deposit, or maybe they don't have the money to pay, you can't say, you know, oh, you already paid for the room, but we can't give you the room. So what you do is you put them on COD or cash on delivery. So basically what it means is they can stay at the room, but any other hotel facilities, let's say they want to eat at a restaurant, they want to go to the spa, they cannot charge the room, but they have to pay with cash.
Okay.
Or they have to pay on the spot for the credit card. Now, that's one of the reasons we collect deposit, because it's actually easier for the guests. All the charges, they can charge the room, and we just deduct from deposit.
Oh.
Right. So I believe that should be all. You seem to really understand most of what I'm teaching. Alright, so that should be all. But if you have any questions, you should not hesitate to talk to your superior or come directly to me. I believe that's all.
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
Alright, thank you.